any fish. 14th of December, 2017. And I just had to touch on this one. The Pope, don't argue with the devil. He's much more intelligent. This is the Telegraph. And first thing you see is an image of the devil. Not just the devil. This is the locust of the pit. Look at how this is a young child. And this is encouraged and welcomed in the Catholic faith, primarily in Central South America, Mexico. A boy poses for a portrait in his devil costume at the procession symbolizing the fight between good and evil that celebrates the Virgin of the Immaculate Conception. Come on now, Catholics. You don't worship to the Virgin. Look at though, he's got the teeth of the lion, the hair of the woman, the wings, all of it right there. Crazy. And it's encouraged. But this is what the Pope says. The devil's more intelligent than mere mortals and should never be argued with, Pope Francis has warned. Okay. I don't know any Christians that argue with the devil, but I digress. Satan is not a metaphor or a nebulous concept, but a real person, he says. Armed with dark powers. Well, he's got it kind of backwards. It is the dark powers that occupy the real people through the temptations and lusts of this world, which permeate everything. He is evil. He's not like mist. Yes, he is like mist. Again, it's dark and secret and like a smoke, like a mist. That's exactly what he does. He does diffuse. And yes, he occupies people. This man is so misleading to his people, it's ridiculous. I'm convinced that one must never converse with Satan. Of course you don't converse with Satan. If you do that, you'll be lost, he told a Catholic channel, gesticulating with his hands to emphasize his point. He's more intelligent than us, and he will turn you upside down. You hear that? He'll make your head spin. He always pretends to be polite. He does it with priests, with bishops, with popes. That's how he enters your mind. But it ends badly if you don't realize what is happening in time. We should tell him, go away, he said. Not be gone in the name of Christ. No, no. Jesus is not mentioned in this article one single solitary time as he addresses the goats here in the serpent head at the Vatican. Please look into that. The Pope is speaking from the mouth of the serpent at the Vatican audience hall. No joke. Pope Francis frequently refers to the devil in his homilies, his sermons on Twitter, followed by 40 million. He uses various terms. Oh, yes, it's a Jesuit thing. He's a Jesuit. Come on, folks. Who is deeply imbued with spiritual exercises of St. Ignatius of Loyola, which allow people to discern the movements of the good and bad spirit. Really? Well, I believe that Mr. Jesuit Francis indeed can discern the movements of the good and evil spirits. But he never mentions Jesus. Let me just show you this real quick. 1 John 4:1, Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets have gone out into the world. Hereby know ye that the Spirit of God, every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world. Okay? Not one mention of Jesus Christ in this entire article, people. As he preaches from the largest satanic literal temple on the planet, the Vatican. You gotta get with the program, you Catholics. I know you love Jesus, but you are certainly following an Antichrist figure. For him, this is real. These are not metaphors. And this is for the Pope they're talking about here. The one who can discern the movements of good and bad spirit. He speaks nowadays, and some Catholics may be taken aback by it. A lot of people are uncomfortable with the idea of evil being real. Really. But anyone who knows the spirituality of the Jesuits will not be surprised. 3 years ago, the Argentinian pontiff told a convention of exorcists from around the world that they were doing sterling work in combating the devil's works. Wrong, wrong, wrong. He said that exorcists need to show the love and welcome of the church for the possessed by evil. This is just so sick. In 2013, during an address to crowds of the faithful in St. Peter's Square, he said the devil often appears disguised as an angel and slyly speaks his words to us. Okay, where's the mention of Jesus here, Pope? Unbelievable. He shares stories about the devil's devious ways. Really? I'm sorry, I have to stop here before I start using cuss words. But you cannot just dismiss the fact that this man is of the Antichrist spirit. He is a liar and a deceiver. He says it here in his own words. From his own serpent mouth, the Jesuit. Okay? I don't know who I'm trying to convince, but they put this stuff right out in front of us, and this man sure does get an awful lot of positive attention around the world. And, you know, this world is fallen, people. And if you don't know Christ, you know, this man does not even mention the name of Jesus. And when they do, they essentially... I can't even tell you. Anyway, I just wanted to share that with you guys. I do hope you have a good day. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,